Time the DCF is such a thing. Every time I ask one of my team members to do a DCF analysis, every time he comes with a different number. The right level of price to earning and price to book for a different company. How do we, it is a completely subjective thing. Sometimes you may say that 10 is good, 10 P is good, sometimes you may say 30 P is good and 25 P is good. How do we, link that valuation, so-called quick back of the envelope valuation matrix to the more scientific or comprehensive way of measuring, which is the DCF value. How do we link that? So that is what I am going to address in the today's session. When we say good company means, what are some of these different instances where those companies are trading, this at a different valuation levels, and from there, I will show you the linkage in the form of Excel. What is the different characteristic of a company's financials are like this? What should be the PE multiple? So that will be like a Bible. So that's how that's your frame of reference where you can work on. These are all these are all confusing signals. Somebody says you should buy a company with good technology, or great entry barriers, low cost of production, because they should probably deserve a high PE multiple. But it's not happening that way. How to take that into the price or a PE multiple? How do we actually process that information into the PE multiple and what price you buy? So it is EBITDA margin high or profit margin high does not mean anything, but their large market opportunity not necessarily means a good PE multiple. It is not all of these qualitative factors that we've discussed so far not necessarily translates to a very high PE multiple. All the things that we've discussed so far, brands, distribution, franchise, monopoly, entry barriers, low cost product, access to the natural resources, these are all non-financial ratios, okay? But they're important things to have. I'm not saying that they're not important, they're very important things to have. But, how are they helping you to decide at a PE multiple? High margin means that automatically high PE? No. A low margin could be high PE and high margin could be low PE stock. And vice versa, even in the same in the case of asset turnover, even this financial ratios like asset turnover and the margin is not necessarily means if they're good, not necessarily means that you should have a good PE multiple. Then what is it that the PE multiple? So how are the fund managers operating in this world? What are they looking at? By assigning different PE multiple for different companies. That is what I am trying to address this in the in the next the Excel sheet that we prepared. There is a proper study and understanding of a value, and you link that to the valuation ratio that we look at, the brands and entry barriers and all of these things. If they lead to the superior return on capital employed, then probably the company will have a higher PE multiple. So all of these qualitative factors should lead to the superior return on capital employed and also should have a good growth opportunity. Only in that situation the company trades at a higher PE multiple. We are trying to do is that we have arrived at a value of a DCF value and that DCF value of a company. And DCF value of the company divided by the first year EPS or 1 year forward EPS, you get a PE, right? So you don't, so that's how you arrive at the PE from the DCF value itself, okay? So these are the PE multiples derived from the DCF valuation. Growth has more relevance when the ROE of the company or industry is very good. Okay, so the ROE, for all of that growth, you are going to earn at a lesser investment capacity, so your future cash flows look much better. How do you address the sick, the PE is fine, but what level of those earnings, is also important, So, especially the commodity companies, one has to be careful, and I'll give you an example here. Hindalco, for instance, March 2007 was trading at just a 5 PE. But in the subsequent 1 year, the stock was down 60%. Okay, so that's because that year's profits were exceptionally high because during that period commodity price was high. and when the commodity prices collapses, you know, the profits go away, and then you not get that return. So you know, the discussion that we looked at is in a normalized earnings growth, not a one bumped up profits or something like that. And similarly, if you had bought in the March 2016 at 18 PE, you know, you would made a 70% returns. You know, even at the higher PE multiple you bought, you know, you made a higher return. So that you have to be careful, because you know, these underlying things are very, very cyclical.